Hello friends, I'm Naval Yemul, working as the assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see the programs on C++ part 4. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to understand basic programs of C++. Content of this video is programs on C++. So first program, the simple program to check whether a number is even or odd using if else statement. So looking at the basic four videos, we'll come to know that the header files and the simple programs. So we'll directly continue with the program. Hash include iostream, int main. Here I have taken one variable, that is number, and after that cout, enter an integer. Whatever the user enters as an integer, that is stored in number. If number percent, it is also called as module, is divided by 2, that is equal to 0, means whatever the user enters, if it is divisible by 2 and if the remainder is 0, we get the number is even, else the number which is entered by the user is odd. So there is a simple program to check whether the given number is even or odd. So the output: enter an integer. If the user enters 5, 5 is a odd. So the second program, C++ program to check if a year is a leap year or not. So we'll start the program here, taking one variable called as int, enter a year. Whatever the year is entered by the user is stored in a variable called year. There is the same logic again. If year module 4 is equal to 0, that is the year entered by the user is divisible by 4, and we have one more condition, we are using nested if else condition here, or nested if else statement here. If the same year is divisible by 100 also, as well as 400 also, then the year is a leap year. For example, if we take 2000 as a year, it is divisible by 4, it is divisible by 100, as well as divisible by 400. Then 2000 is called a leap year. So there are three conditions. It is 4, 100 and 400. So the program is continued in the next slide. Else, cout year is not a leap year. Else, year is a leap year. Or else year is not a leap year. So return 0. For this, the output will be, if you enter a year 2019 is not a leap year. So we'll see next program, that is C++ program to find the largest of two numbers. So hash include iostream.h header file and int main. We are taking three variables here, that is a, b and the big. So we need to take two numbers from the user, and whatever the two numbers are entered by the user are stored in a and b. I am using if statement again. If a is greater than b, then big is equal to a. So the a will be bigger here in this case, else b will be bigger. So the final output will be, the biggest of the two numbers is, we are calling B, which is bigger, return 0. So the final output will be, enter two numbers 3 and 4, the biggest of the two numbers is 4. So try to think on a program to find the largest of the three numbers. Pause the video for a few seconds and try to think. Okay. Here the program is similar to finding the largest of two numbers. Here we need to take one more variable extra than what we have taken in the finding for the two numbers. So here we are taking A, B, C as a variable and big as one more variable. So we need to take the three numbers from the user, that is A, B and C. Whatever the user enters, that is stored in A, B and C. We assume that A is biggest in the first case. Let A, that is biggest number, than B and C. If that big is less than B, that big is nothing but A, that A is less than B, and we are using nested if conditions here. If B is greater than C and B is big is equal to B, else this can be one condition, else big is equal to C, so it can be A can be bigger, B can be bigger and C can be bigger. The program is continued in the next slide. So else if big is less than C, if C is greater than B, big is equal to C, else big is equal to B, or else big is equal to A. So the biggest number will be amongst A, B or C. Once the user enters three numbers, that is 2, 3, 4, the biggest number will be 4. So we'll see the next program to calculate average and percentage marks of a student. So here we are taking int marks 5, that 5 refers to, we are taking 5 subjects marks as an input, and we are taking one more data type, that is float sum. See out, enter marks obtained in 5 subjects, and those 5 subjects are physics, chemistry, maths, CS and English. So here we are using a for loop. In for studying or for knowing more about the for loop, you refer the videos of my colleague Udgesar, which is described in detail for the for loops. So for for loop, we are using initialization, then assigning the value, then incrementation. If I is equal to 0 and if I is less than equal to 5, less than 5 and I plus plus, here whatever the user enters 5 numbers, that is 5 marks, that is stored in marks. Then we are using a condition here, sum is equal to sum plus mark. Then the program is continued in the next slide. So float here, average is equal to sum divided by 5. Whatever the sum of all 5 numbers was summed, that is divided by 5. So from there we get a average. So we are taking one more variable, that is percent, PRC. Percent is equal to sum divided by 500, that is summation of all the 5 digits divided by 500 into 100. So we get in percentage. So the final output will be average marks, and we are calling average, and percentage is equal to, we are calling the variable percent and showing it with a symbol also, return 0. So you get the first statement as enter the marks obtained in those 5 subjects, and if the user enters these values, the average marks will be 76, and the simple formula is taking the sum of all 5 and divided by 5, you get average. And for percentage, sum divided by 500, if each subject is of 100 marks, divided by 500 into 100, you get in percentage. So references, these are the references which I have used. Thank you.